we eat like that until, you know, we're forced into civilized way of consuming food. I mean, yeah. Essentially, you know, we eat with our hands and smash it all over our face. I want to get back to that, really, just sitting in a high chair and putting pasta sauce all over me.
This is What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix is a joke radio.
This is really exciting. This tattoo redo popped off.
It popped off. It's on the top. It's trending in all these different countries. It's in the top 10 list of all these different countries. And I'm an eternal optimist. And I know Fortune kind of has the same vibe where, you know, we tend to lead with optimism and
right.
a good heart. I don't know about Tom, but for the most part, I think so. I think life has beat him down a little bit.
Am I the dark side of this?
You're the salt. You're the salt in the show. I was severely optimistic about this show, so much so that I made a bet with the executive producer. I said, I guarantee you we're going to be top trending. Mm-hmm. And he's like, all right, well, not that he wasn't confident. He just, you know, mm-hmm. wasn't sure, you know.
Right. Sure.
And so I made a bet for a new pair of shoes. So mama's going to cash in on that.
Right.
New pair of sneakers coming my way.
How'd you guys team up?
He had heard about me for a few years and just wanted me as the host. I guess I was the one that he thought could carry it the way he saw it. Mm-hmm. And we met years ago before quarantine and it was all set to go. And then quarantine sort of took us off our tracks like it did for so many people and so many industries. And then Netflix still wanted to do it, luckily, you know, and they were so freaking supportive. I mean, you guys know the year I've had. I mean, everybody's had a tough year, but I had to film this in the process of my mother being sick and essentially losing her. And Netflix was so, so supportive and so understanding of life outside of production, which sometimes isn't the case. You know, sometimes you feel like a dollar sign and not a human being, but luckily we got it done.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you, it is so sweet that it is trending right now. It would kind of suck if it was a shitty show and my mom is dead too.
Oh, man.
That'd be terrible.
Angelina, you held it together, but I also feel like you had internal turmoil watching your mother.
Oh, my God. My hands are like still shaking.
Are you ready to show her her new tattoo?
I'm so ready to see it.
No peeking.
Okay. No peeking.
Just clean your belly button one more time.
If you're ready to look at your tattoo, Elizabeth, open your eyes and look towards the mirror.
Oh, God. Oh, wow.
That's not telling me enough.
Oh, my God, those are eyes. It's really beautiful.
Oh, thank God.
It's really, really beautiful. Oh my God, this is by far the nicest piece that I have.
Yes. For sure.
You can't see it, he's gone.
He's gone.
I was so worried because I just felt that it was bigger, but it's just like the perfect size.
It must have helped to have like a gig to go do.
It was because it's like, you know, this is my calling. This is what I do and how I contribute. And it definitely gave me purpose in a time where I felt helpless. So yeah, it definitely anchored me and centered me and got me focused in something that I, you know, I feel like I was born to do. And it may be the eternal optimism is the thing that keeps me sort of feeling like I have to stay positive and all of that. But I just, I'm, you know, I'm grateful and I really can't wait for Brad Pitt to see it. And then we can finally really consummate our love.
Oh my God. You never let up with this guy. He's not your guy. I told you a thousand times.
Fortune, Tom and I, he says that Brad Pitt's not my guy, which I'm really trying to not be triggered by.
It's so rude. It's so rude that he would say that because
thank you.
No, you deserve
Brad
better.
Pitt is
Brad.
Your guy.
No, look, Brad's great for a lot of things. He's very
Even
hot.
Jack thinks Brad Pitt's hot.
Yeah, but that's why we don't need that.
Who do you see me with, Tom? Who do you want? Who would you be happy with me walking down the aisle to?
Eric Griffin, maybe, or
No comedians, Tom. There's no. Giannis Papas was the last one. He was the last of the Mohican comedians.
What? You were with Giannis?
Oh, I didn't know
that.
We
were together for years. Yeah, we were together for 4 years. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Back in the day.
Oh, okay.
He's a sweet guy.
I don't think I knew you there.
He's a little hairy, but
He's very hairy, but yeah. He's very, very intelligent. And now he's like best friends with John Stamos, which I feel is a personal attack.
Which you do love John Stamos.
I do. And now
he's taken. So
he's taken, and my ex and him are like BFFs. Like, what's going on?
You think he was doing it to get your attention?
You know, honestly, I think that's what it is. Can you imagine if I was such a narcissist? I'm like, they're obviously friends because of me.
Because of me.
I thought you said Giannis-ly.
Giannis-ly? We need to tell him he's got to make that a title. Giannis-ly?
That should be a podcast. Giannis-ly?
Oh, I'm going to text him. That's a great title.
So y'all are still friends.
Yeah, we're cordial now. You know, we're friends and friendly. Yeah. And he's got a beautiful wife and a baby now.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, so do you.
Yeah, well... All right, so not Brad Pitt. I want to bring her to Vito's Pizza. Vito is an amazing, amazing pizza guy, and I just know that Jesse is going to fall in love. Vito's going to fall in love with Jessimae.
Oh, this is true.
Yeah.
Tom is trying to do is to get free pizza for the rest of his life, and he's trying to hook Vito up with one of his friends. We all know.
No, this I'm not trying to hook you up. He's going to look at you like a niece.
Oh, well, you don't know some of the places I'm from.
You don't know my uncles.
You don't know my uncles.
Jessimae's like, don't touch me.
I'm like, that sounds like an awkward family get together that I am here for. Especially if I know the food's going to be good.
Stop moving, dude.
Don't
you're
make
a
me
nightmare.
Move. I feel like you're really close to my hand.
Stop talking. Don't move!
I'm sorry! Ah!
Can you not move? Go on, crack it down. Oh, perfect. That's amazing.
Oh, what is this area?
She makes people do this all day long. And
now she can't handle it.
Yeah, she can't hang.
Where is the loyalty?
We're done.
Rose, you're rude.
I am rude, because you were moving so much.
All right, Jessimae, you ready? Let's see your reaction,
everybody.
Did I mess
it up? You did, actually.
Ready?
I did? Yeah, you moved a lot. That's why I was yelling at you the whole time.
Damn. Well,
she wasn't kidding. You know, they have wristbands on sale now.
You could get a lot of beads. You could wear a big bracelet or something.
So basically I'm gonna need to cover this
up. Keep the paper towel on it. Hold the paper towel.
Okay. So when can I look at it?
Go for it.
You hate it?
That's super clean for moving around.
Look how great it is.
Portrait of Rose.
Do you actually like it though?
Oh my gosh.
Oh! I wanted to ask you about that show that you did at the Wilbur Theater. That looked like fun.
Oh my God, you guys are gonna love this. So it was for, you know, John Stites, who does Operation Comedy for all the veterans. He does all those shows. Their first show back after quarantine. Uh-huh. And it's, I mean, the bill was amazing. It was Bill Burr and Saget, Eric Griffin, who you're trying to get me to marry, and myself.
Uh-huh. See?
And the booker takes a picture of the poster in the hallway, in the foyer, and it said...
I didn't see it. Her name was crazy.
My last name was... It said Jessimae Perloff.
Perloff?
P-E-R-L-O-F.
You're like,
and
cool,
you know,
cool shows, weird son.
And she goes, look, you're on the marquee. I'm like, no, I'm not. Some hillbilly dentist is, but not me. I don't know who Jessimae Perloff is, but I bet you can get a deal on a crown.
It looked like a fun show, though.
It was so much fun. It was sold out, at least 2,000 people, and probably all have COVID now, but it was so worth it, you know? No, it was it was done well. It was amazing. It was so much fun to come back and make it feel like everything was kind of normal for a night and, you know, have crowds be so appreciative of being able to get out of the house and laugh and enjoy.
So great.
Comedy.
Jeff Ross's story seemed pretty scary. You know, he was all vaxxed up and he got really knocked out by it.
He was supposed to be on that show that I did. And him and I believe John Mayer both, I don't think John Mayer was sick, but he was about to go on a big tour and was just being cautious and decided to not show up. And so Bob Saget sang, and I'm sure that satisfied everybody.
That's funny.
Practically the same.
Yeah.
Danny Tanner on a freaking guitar. Hello. Childhood dreams met. The fact that I walked in and Danny Tanner knew who I was. I'm like, all right, gonna go walk into the ocean now and never return. I'm fine. my ex is best friends with Stamos. Bob Saget knows who I am. I can die. I can
That's
die.
What's up. That's what's up.
I went through a breakup over the pandemic. We were engaged and living in my mom's basement.
Oh, no. The basement love didn't work.
I guess not. The thing about it is that okay, obviously I'm a comic, so I'm crazy. We had gotten each other's names tattooed. So this has been like a journey of covering up the name because we got it more than once.
No. What? You can't get multiple times, Natalie.
Natalie.
Come on.
Yeah. Big?
Yeah. Oh no, how big was it?
This was a name. That I covered it up.
Wow.
On your collarbone. That's your whole collarbone.
And then where was the other one?
We have an ankle, a calf, and a finger.
That is a lot.
Natalie, you have to get this guy back. You have to get him back.
Have to get back together.
Does he have a common name where we could find another boy who has the same name?
No, I got the last name.
No.
Yeah, I know.
Come on.
Natalie.